Hey everyone, my name is Michael, I'm the developer of Voxel MRT, and today I'm going to show you the basics of this game. So if you're interested in more deeper information, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, I will explain it in separate videos, but today it's just about the basics. Let's go. The game is about building yourself a castle and defending it against enemies. You play as a RPG type of character. In this case, I'm an archer, but there are other classes to choose from in the level character designer. So the goal of this game is to destroy these things over there. There are three on this map. They are spawners. This one is a big one, a boss spawner. And the ones on the sides are little spawners. So in order to destroy them, you will need some help because they are really hard to destroy. They generate HP relatively fast, and there will be many enemies if you get them to low health. So in order to do this, let's get right into building our castle. You have your little building menu over here. The first two buildings you always have to build are these two. The main building where all of your villagers live, and the stockpile where basically your resources get stored and your building guys will live. You will need some resources, so let's get that rolling. You will see this guy will build some stuff. When he's finished, the woodcutter will spawn over there and produce wood for us. You can chop down trees by yourself, but we are lazy and we don't want to do that. So this guy is the woodcutter. Like I said, he will go and do the dirty work for us. So in order to survive for a while in this game, you have to produce food as well, because your villagers are hungry and they will get angry and at you and leave the castle if you don't have food for them. So let's get that done as well. There are two different types of food in the game at the moment. The one with the wheat and the chicken farm, which produces eggs. You will need it at some maps because wheat doesn't grow in every map. If there is snow or in the desert, wheat won't grow, so you have to look what type of food production you can build. I will add more food production in the future, but for now these are the only tools. Because I like beer, I added beer to the game as well. Your villagers will be angry at you as well if you don't give them beer. It's pretty much made the same way as the wheat or bread. You have these hops farms. They grow kind of slow, and this guy here will make beer out of the hops. So we have everything except for the quarry. The stone is randomly generated. It's sometimes over there, sometimes over there. You just place your quarry on top of it and it does the rest for you. So now we have all necessary productions, but we won't have enough villagers for that. In order to fix this, we will need some houses. There are different types of houses, the basic ones and the bigger ones. The bigger ones need more resources but have more room. You have to be careful. As more villagers you have, as more food you will need, obviously. So let's speed this up. We have one free villager left, so let's use him to get another building guy. While these guys are working, I will explain you some of the other things. So this is the peace timer. While it's above zero, no enemies will spawn and you can't hurt the spawners or other players. You can disable this or you can make it longer, however you want. While these guys are busy, let's go and visit the spawners over there. You can create your own maps, so that is one that will be in the game right from start. But if you want, you can get your own. So this is the small spawner. If you attack it, enemies will come out of it. For example, foxes, wolves, or other guys. Let's attack it, because why not? So you have different abilities. This guy can spawn this wolf guy. He will help you tank a little bit and deal some damage. It's pretty much your ultimate. You have other skills like this one as well. And a trap. If anyone walks through it, he will get some damage, like you can see. Every class has different abilities, so make sure to check them all out if you play the game. Obviously, in the time I killed these guys, this thing regenerated all of its health. So, like I said, it's pretty much impossible to destroy them alone. You have to get yourself an army. This one is the boss spawner. There will be a ogre boss if you are at the last wave or after some time when you play the game. An ogre will spawn and attack your castle. The ogre can destroy buildings, so you better try to kill him before he kills your whole castle, basically. At the beginning, there are just some goblins and spiders and stuff. The goblins are pretty weak. They don't deal much damage, but they hit a few times. So if you are not able to dodge it, they will pretty much kill you. There are a lot more enemies in the game, but I won't show them right now. So how are our guys doing? Yeah, okay. So you can see that's basically the most important stuff. You build yourself an economy. You make walls around it that enemies can't go in. You have towers that increase the range of your archers. You have a gatehouse and other stuff. This thing will tell you when enemies come because it's kind of random. And you can recruit yourself some people in here. But I won't show this now as well. You can upgrade your units with this thing. You can upgrade yourself. So there is a lot to discover. But I just wanted to show you the basics of the game. So if you enjoyed it, if you think it's interesting, make sure to subscribe to the channel. I will make more update videos. The game will release pretty much in a month, I hope. And make sure to leave a like to help me. See you soon. Bye.